Hi, I'm Paulshinn. Welcome back to the YouTube channel that considers OK Boomer to be a compliment. So I'm back here again, and yes, I'm talking about LED headlights again. And the reason is there's a new kind of LED headlight that just came out recently. So Newton Wells has an eBay page that he sells these on, and he kept commenting on one of the videos about how there is LED lights now that are just as bright and not that bluish white light. He says they're natural, almost yellowish looking light, if you will. So he sent me a couple of these, and today we're going to try them out. In my first two videos, we already decided that the LED headlights are not only brighter, but it made it safer to drive a Model A at night. So big thank you to Newton Wells for sending these so I can check them out. Now, if these suck, I'm going to send them back and I'm going to say so in the video. Trust me, I'm totally honest about this. But if they're cool, I'm going to send them a check instead. So the big difference between these and the LEDs that have come out before it, mainly people complain that the previous generation are too blue looking. Well, they're not really blue looking, they're white. They're somewhere in the 6,000 range, somewhere in there. But supposedly these are a little bit more like the incandescent light yellowish color that we're used to. So let's find out. I'm gonna swap this one out. We're gonna do some experimenting. So there they are. All right, there's the old one. I have to remember which one's which. Okay, and that looks to be on low beam. So there's the difference in color between the previous generation and the new generation that Newton's selling on eBay. So are they bright? I don't know. We'll have to find out. I have to wait till it gets a little bit darker. Then I'm going to refocus this, and then we're going to go drive it, and we're going to see what it looks like. Time for another beautiful sunset from high atop our ridge in beautiful Calaveras County. All right, time to get to work. In my previous videos, I gave specific instructions on how I focus Model A headlights. It's actually very simple, but you should go back and watch those videos. So take the lens off and push the reflector back into the bucket as far as you can, and then turn the focus adjuster screw on the back of the headlight bucket until you get the smallest image possible. It's exactly the same exercise as focusing a mag light or any other flashlight with a focusable beam. Then when you're done with that, you put the lens back on. The lens is going to spread the light out sideways, horizontally. It's not really going to spread it out vertically. So get your image the smallest you can vertically on whatever you're shooting the lights against, or in this case, my shop door. So with the new 3000 Kelvin LED light on the left or driver's side bucket, and the previous generation 6000 Kelvin LED headlight on the passenger side bucket, you can really tell the difference in light, not only because of the light color and light temperature, but the new yellowish light, the 3000 Kelvin, for whatever reason just seems to bounce off of things easier. So as I pull up to the back of my pickup truck here, you can see the difference in the yellow light versus the whiter LED light, but you can really tell it once you get on the road. So here we are on a country road with no street lights and not a lot of illumination. You can tell that the things on the left side, driver's side of the road, you can just see them a little bit easier. Now, when I switch to high beams, they don't change angle like an incandescent bulb does, but they do get brighter. So instead of one row of LEDs illuminated on each side of the bulb, you have two rows of LEDs illuminated. So going down this road that's a little bit bumpy, you can see each bump coming up in the road on the left side just a tiny bit easier. Now, are they night and day different from the 6000 Kelvin LED bulbs? No, they're not really. But they do look different. And as I pull up to the end of this dead end road, we're going to get a look out onto the horizon, and you can tell just a little bit. On the driver's side, you can see just a tiny bit more of the stuff out on the other side of that canyon. So how do they look to oncoming traffic? Are they really blinding? Well, let's find out. So the Model A is in front, followed by a fairly new Jeep right behind it. The Model A with the 3000 Kelvin LED lights, the Jeep with halogens. Here's the exact same test, but this time both vehicles are on high beams. Now let's take a drive with the 3000 Kelvin LEDs in both headlight buckets. As you can see, The definition of things is just a little bit better than the 6000 Kelvin LED headlights. So I could imagine that somebody could make the argument that LEDs don't illuminate as well as incandescent, but as soon as they switch to these new bulbs, I think that argument totally goes out the window. So what's the verdict? Am I going to be sending these LED bulbs back to Newton, or am I going to be sending them a check? It is a no-brainer. I'm sending a check. I absolutely love these new LED bulbs. Not only because the slight yellowish color just looks right in a Model A, it doesn't have that pure white or that slight blue light to it, has that vintage look. Not only that, but this color temperature is fantastic. It lights up things on the road a little bit better. You can just see the reflected light off of things a little more clearly, a little more definition than with the pure white LED bulbs. I liked those, but I love these. So yes, I'm keeping these in this car. I'm sending them a check, and I'm ordering another set too. I'm going to put a link down below for Newton's eBay auction, and eventually that auction is going to expire. I'm going to also link to Newton's eBay profile. So if he has another auction going with these LED bulbs for sale, you can just click on that. That'll take you to his current auctions, and hopefully he'll have these for sale. Now, after the last couple of videos that I published on LED bulbs, the manufacturers and the suppliers sold out of those LED bulbs. That video was very popular. Everybody bought up all the LED bulbs there were. So if Newton runs out of these after this video publishes, please be patient, but these are absolutely worth it. And I know that the people on the web forums are going to rip me to shreds on this. No, you can't focus LEDs. Paulshinn doesn't know what he's talking about. Paulshinn just puts out false information. The web forums, there's a lot of good people there, but there's a few people that are just really negative all the time. And even if you show them, look, you saw with your own eyes in this video how I focused these LED headlights, they still deny it. So just remember that. When you're on the forums, if you're asking people on the forums questions about this, you saw it with your own eyes on this video. But the two or three experts that kind of populate those web forums and insist they're right no matter what to the death, they're still going to say Paulshinn's an idiot. He doesn't know what he's talking about. So just take that with a grain of salt. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. I will catch you on the next video, and I'll be able to see where I'm going when I do.
So these new LEDs will run on 6 or 12 volts and positive or negative ground, so it doesn't matter what electrical system you're running, and they draw an awful lot less current. Each one of these draws less than an amp. So with two LED headlights, you're talking about maybe 1.5–2 amps tops. Huge thanks going out to the people that made this video possible, Greg Heiss, Jim Quinlan, and thanks to Ben Evans for your donations. I appreciate it very much. Stop by the store, check out the shirts. I'll catch you on the next video. Thank you so much for watching. God bless.